Hey there, welcome back. So SvelteKit feels confusing. This plus page, plus layout things is weird. Don't worry anymore. In this video, I'll show you how to create a simple to-do application with SvelteKit in a speedrun way. So let's check it out. This is a speedrun video where we will create a simple SvelteKit application using some Tailwind to add some niceties, but it's a simple to-do application. Why a to-do application? Because it's simple. Everyone knows how a to-do application should work, so we can focus on the SvelteKit features instead of the application domain or logic. Let's jump in. So what is SvelteKit? SvelteKit is a full-stack web application framework. It's built on top of Svelte for the rendering layer and use web APIs for everything else. Find information here, kit.svelte.dev. So let's go to the docs, create a project. Let's copy this, jump into the terminal. Let's use pmpm and let's create a SvelteKit to do app. Let's use a skeleton project. So bare bones scaffolding, nothing there. Let's use TypeScript, Eslint, prettier, and nothing else for now. And there you go. So let's jump into the to-do application folder. You can see here that there's a README file, the package.json file, the SRC folder where everything that you'll write will live, and some other configuration files. So now let's add Tailwind to the mix. And for that, we'll use this community script as built add. You can see a video about that here. And just jump here to Tailwind CSS, copy the script. This will install and configure Tailwind into your SvelteKit application in the easiest way possible. Let's install the dependencies. Tailwind is not required at all. You can just write plain old CSS, but it will be nice to use. But let's see how that works. Now let's edit it. The first thing to notice is that the SvelteKit application lives under the SRC folder. And here you'll find a roads folder. This is important because here is where your pages, quote unquote, will live. This is the main entry point. And this file, src/plus page.svelte, is the main page. The convention in SvelteKit is to use these names with the plus sign to identify the files that represent something inside the framework. Let's jump back here. So the routing in SvelteKit is a folder-based routing. That means that folders inside the routes folder will represent a page. Each of these folders can have one page.svelte, one plus page.svelte file that represent a component that is the page that will be rendered on the screen. And it can have associated a file named as plus page.ts or JS, depends if you're using TypeScript or JavaScript. This will perform some server-side processes like loading data, but also will run on the client. And if you want to perform only server-side logic, you need to use the plus page.server.ts file. Beside that, you will find the plus error files that represent a way to render error pages. But more important than that are the layout pages. The plus layout svelte component is the one that will wrap the entire routing below them. So you'll have at least one plus layout page. That's this one in this case, that only renders the slot. So every children will live under it. But in here you can wrap it with a container, and that is background slate. So everything under it will be with that background. But this plus layout svelte can live inside each of your routing folders, so will be nested layouts. Beside that, you can use the same logic for the plus page files, that the plus layout.ts or js, it behaves exactly like that to allow the svelte component to load data from the server, and the plus layout server.ts that will perform only server-side code. And if for some reason you need to create some, for example, API endpoint, you can use the plus server.ts file. to create REST APIs. Let's go back to the code. So we have this. Let's see how this looks for now. PMPM dev. This will run this file. This is what we have on the screen. Very bad. So let's add more full. Okay, everything have that color and set the text to be gray 100. Okay, this is the current site. The layout is just setting the class for the whole page. Let's go to the plus page file. And this is exactly what we have this. So let's delete it. Let's add some container here. And here we will create our first step for the to-do application. This is a form. Yes, a simple form with method post, action to be the same route. Let's now add some inputs here. As you can see, pretty straightforward HTML. Let's see how this looks. Awful, obviously. Let's fix this and make it look better. Now it looks better, right? So it's a very straightforward, just HTML. Let's add some svelte to this. The thing that we will add using the svelte templating language is the priorities here. So let's create a little array with priorities, and let's say that it have a value of 1 and a title of low, value 2, title mid. Now let's use svelte to render that array. For that, you can use the each syntax and say reference the priorities array as item. And here you can just render the option. The value will be item.value and item.title to show. And there you go. It's rendered. It's the problem with the colors here. So there we have our form to create the elements. Now let's render a table to show the to-do items, and that will be just a table. Let's style it after. So far, so good. This is simple HTML stuff with some classes from Tailwind, but if you prefer plain old CSS, you can just write a tag here and write your CSS as always. This CSS will be a scope to this page and will not pollute the global scope. But the most important part is to handle this form. For that, we will use form actions. This is the way that SvelteKit handles the forms. Basically creates an object in the server side file, this one, and that will handle the communication between frontend and backend. So let's create this. We can copy this one and we can create a plus page.server.ts file, copy this, and we have our actions. The actions can be named. The name for this action will be the default one. Let's see if we can console log the thing that we will receive. Let's go back to the page here and to the form. So title, description, and click submit. The page refresh, nothing happens on the client more than the refresh. Let's go to the console here and you can see that something was logged. Let's see what was logged. Let's go back to the server side code. Let's grab the request object from here and let's retrieve the form data by doing request.formData. And we know what data comes through the wire. So form data.get title to string, description, and priority. Let's console this. Let's focus on the terminal. Send the data from the frontend. And there you go. You just capture the data from the client side into the server side code with a form action. But it weirds in the current state of the web to have those refresh every time you submit something. To avoid that, you can go back to the front-end side code and use an action named useEnhance that can be imported from app forms. This will allow you to handle the form in a progressive enhanced way. So if I can submit, there is no refresh, but the information is here. Now, what we can do with this information, which will store this information somewhere and then retrieve that information to render in the table. Let's talk about storing data. Since you are in the server here, you can perform SQL stuff, write files, whatever you need, or talking to other APIs. Let's do some SQLite here just to showcase a thing. For that, you'll use another package. Let's install that pnpm add better SQLite3. With that installed, we can go back and run the application again, and let's set up the database. Let's create a new folder named leave database with a file that is SQLite.js. Open that file. Let's set up the database with as todo.db. There is no options here. Let's create now functions to insert todo item will be a item. Let's add a type here, todo item. First, before inserting anything into the database, we need to create the tables that this database will hold. So for that, let's just quickly set up the thing. So let's create the table. For that, let's open the database, perform the corresponding SQL code, and the table has been created. Tables, there you go. Get out from here and run the application again. Now we need to prepare the SQL statement, and that is done by using db.prepare and insert into todos, and we will insert the title, the description, and the priority. Now do this sql.run. We can pass the values to it, so, and return the changes. Let's go back to the server side code and perform the SQL. So that means that we can just call insert into todo item. It's imported there, and the item is created by the title, description, and parse ENT from priority, and this is priority, and it's failing because this is possible null. So that okay, now that is inserted, we can just return this. Will return the changes, and we can return the changes. Now this insert stuff into the database, but how you can retrieve that into the page? That is done using the load function. To load your data, you can use this snippet of code. This is the load function that will accept some parameters. In this case, we'll receive nothing. We need to retrieve the to-do items from something, right? And return the items here. This is performed only on the server side, so it's safe to perform SQL functions. So let's do get to-do items. Let's go to the previous file where we have all of our database functions, get to do items, and will be SQL DB prepare select everything from to do's. So now let's return SQL.all. Go back to the server side code. Let's import that, and we should have our data. How we can make sure of that? Let's go here and export a new prop that's named data. Let's console log that data. There's nothing in our database. So let's create the first to do. This is the first to do item stored in the database. This is a high priority one. Submit it. Now refresh this, and we have one item in our database. So let's render that into the table. That let's go to T body here. Let's use Svelte templating language here. So for each data items as item, close the each. Let's create a table row with item.title, item.description, item.priority. There's a typo here, the description. Let's see. There we go. This doesn't look really good. So let's change the style, and now it looks a little better. So let's create another one. Second to do item, another item into the database, but this is a low priority. We submit it, and we have it directly in our table. If we refresh the application, the data is still there. And there you go. This is a speed run of creating an SvelteKit application for to do's. This was just simple as creating the page with plain old HTML using Svelte templating language to render the options here and to render the data here in the table. But where with SvelteKit server-side capabilities, we were able to handle the form with a form action, insert data into a database, and also load that data into the screen here. So there you go. This is how you create a quick and dirty SvelteKit application. I hope you like it. If you find this useful, please subscribe to the channel because that helps a lot. And since YouTube is a very good recommendation machine, I think this video here will like you a lot. See you in the next one.